So we've seen the impacts of climate change. Fortunately, we already have the solutions. They're just waiting to be rolled out. How would you like to help create a more positive future?
Climate change could be a whole holistic change. The change in the climate, do we either make the decision to take a good look at ourselves and what we're doing and how we're mismanaging the land and mismanaging our mother? Because our Earth is our mother. We all come from there, we all go back there. That's just something that we can't change. But the thing that we can change is our impact. We can change our footprints. We can walk around with big steel cap boots on, or we can kick them off and walk around barefooted and make less impact. And that's a simple euphemism to explain how we can make a difference.
We need to be mindful of what we do and help support each other and look at some activities that we shouldn't be doing that won't provide support to the environment, but look for other alternatives, renewable energy, you know, that will help, you know, fight this climate change. Yeah.
Scientists and communities are already taking really important action to rescue endangered species. One famous example from Western Australia concerns the Western Australian swamp tortoise, which was discovered by a schoolboy. It had been thought to be extinct for over 100 years. This schoolboy discovered one in a swamp near Perth. And without that discovery, the species just would have slipped into oblivion and no one would have known. But because the species was identified and the specimen taken to the museum, the swamps were preserved and the habitat of that species and the species itself survives to this day.
One of the hopes I really have is going to renewable energy, electrification of vehicles, in-grid storage of energy, such as big battery technology. I think there are smart, clever ways for us to maintain lifestyle, but also look after the environment and look after the climate.
We need to actually start drawing some of those greenhouse gases out of the air. Now, we can do that with better farming practices, with growing seaweed, with using silicate rocks, with mechanical means for getting CO2 out of the air. So that's really important as well.
The fashion industry has an emissions greater than plane flight. So that you look at the life cycle of a product, a piece of clothing, so that you can repurpose it at some point. So if I have a t-shirt that I wear that has holes in it, it goes to being the gardening t-shirt. Then it goes to being cut down and being a cloth to wipe things down, so that each product you own has a life beyond the point of production life. So the circular economy is to look at the life cycle of all our products and what we do, so that we don't create products to end where the end point is waste.
Some of the solutions I see to climate change are definitely the rise of renewables. I think that's very tangible for Australia being a country with lots of wind and water. We're a very nature-driven country, so I think that's something that definitely sparks hope, not only me, but the rest of my generation as well.
Climate change is definitely a threat, but threats always present opportunities. And the innovation that we're seeing in the energy space, in electricity generation, electric vehicles, adaptive farming systems like regenerative agriculture and lots of other things are a consequence of climate change. So it's not all bad news about climate change. There are opportunities.
My hope is that my community is becoming mobilised because they understand the problems from global heating. We have so many groups that are forming alliances and advocating to corporations and to each level of government. There is hope, but we have to move quickly.
Climate change has given me the opportunity to host wind turbines, and that is the income from those turbines is drought-proof, it's drought-resistant, doesn't depend on the weather. And that's allowed me to employ two people, permanent part-time from Crookwell, my local town, who are really, really happy that I can assure them that their jobs are safe. It doesn't matter if it rains for 5 or 10 years, their jobs are safe. So the mental health aspects of wind turbines have been discussed ad nauseum in the negative, the impacts. Nobody really has talked about the benefits of wind turbines. That is one of the benefits. Apart from my personal benefit by getting the income from the turbines. There's two at least, if not more, people in my local town who are benefiting financially but also mental health-wise from wind turbines.
In Star Trek, they don't go to the new star systems based on coal-based spaceships. It's like there's new technologies that come on board and we learn to do things much smarter and cleaner. That's the whole important thing. We need to be able to do things with renewables, with the ability to regenerate the energy. It's not about mining old energy and burning it once. It's about how do we get something that we can use again and again and again.
A long story short is the gold, the coal, and everything else that we take from our Mother Earth, we don't need to do that. The stuff that we have above the earth is already enough. But the thing is, what we need to do is use different ways. Yeah, a lot of people say that it takes a lot of mining stuff to put up a wind farm, or a lot of silica and that sort of stuff to build solar panels. But the thing is, once they're built, once they're put on the earth to generate the energy that we so-called need, we don't really need it. Like a fire on the ground is good enough. You can cook a feed there, you keep you warm there, and you can keep wolves from the door with it. But the thing is, once we have that infrastructure in place, there's no need to change it. The only thing we have to do is maintain it and look after it. It's pretty simple. That's that side of things. But when it comes to the chemicals and everything else that we pump out into our rivers and take away from our rivers and all that sort of stuff, you know, we need to rethink our actions.
There is hope, but we have to move quickly. Reflecting on our practices and looking towards regenerative and renewable energy can lead us to real solutions. We can change our impact and we can change our footprint.